cos theta. Cos theta is equal to what? 0.32. In the 0.32 you are getting. Okay. That also done. So this is equal. Root 50 is equal to 7.07 into 0.32. So this is the value of this. This is equal to 2.26. 2.26 unit. Any unit that may be here. 2.26 unit you will write. This is the answer to that question. Right? So this is also a very simple question I have explained to you. Right. Okay. This also all of you will note these questions. This is explanation. Projection of one vector along the other vector. You will see that the second vector makes an angle. Which angle it is making? Theta angle. Therefore, along this direction, the projection or the component. We have said component only. Component of this vector along d is equal to f cos theta. Suppose on the other hand, if I ask, what is the projection of this vector d along f? Then you will write d cos theta. Understand? So this is the way how you understand how to do a simple problems in vectors. Right? Next. Another question also I am going to write here. So I will give you a homework question also today that you will do at home, right? Yeah, actually I am not finding time to give the notes, to upload the notes that I will do very soon, because I am working with all the classes. That means the 12th also, because I have to, when before teaching I have to write notes and I have to plan, mentally plan this, and all these are taking a lot of time these days. And also sometimes the internet facility is also strong. In the morning hours we have to wait for that also. So all this actually create a lot of tension. Right? Okay. Now this is a homework question I am writing. The homework, find the scalar product and the vector product. The scalar product and vector product. Vector product of two vectors, vector A is equal to 3i minus 4j plus 5k. Okay? Plus 5k. And vector B is equal to minus 2i plus j minus 3k. This is the question. Scalar product everybody can do. Scalar product means dot product that you have already seen. The first part is done actually. First part already done. That you will practice yourself. You have to do 3i minus 4j plus 5k dot minus 2i plus j minus 3k. You have to do that, already we have done. Next is what? Cross product of the two vectors. Second part is vector A cross vector B. That I'm doing. That also I have explained how to do it. Okay. That is equal to vector A means 3i minus 4j plus 5k cross minus 2i plus j minus 3k. This is the cross product you have to take. Am I correct? So in this case, what you will do? You will take determinants. Determinants, it is like this only, right? That means first you will write I, and here it is j, and here it is k. Then the magnitudes of the first vector. This is xi plus yj plus zk. X is 3, and y is minus 4, and z is plus 5, right? Next is this one. This is ax, AY, AZ. This is BX. BX is equal to 2. BY is equal to 1 plus 1. And BZ is equal to minus 3. Right? How the cross product the two vectors done? That is also very simple. First of all, you write I into, I means unit vector I into this side you will forget, and now this one, that is minus 3, you will write a square bracket like this, minus 4 into minus 3, minus 4 into minus 3, minus 4 into minus 3, minus, then there is a common minus, then this direction, this direction, 1 now, 5, this direction, that is a 5 into 1, right? Yes, this is the first term is over. I into this, minus this into this. This direction, again this direction. 5 into 1. First part is over, first term is over. Plus J into, J means this part. Then you have to take in the reverse direction. 5 into 2. Again, 5 into 2, because both are positive, so it is not put in. 5 into, yeah. Oh, I am sorry. Here it is minus 2. I mean, so I'll write minus 2 here. Okay. 5 into minus 2, 5 into minus 2, minus, 5 into minus 2, minus, again this into this, right, that is 3 into minus 3, you will write. The whole into J, second term is also over, again third term is K, that is K into, K into again 3 into 1, the direct 3 into 1, minus, minus 4 now. That is 3 into 1 minus of minus 2 into minus 4. This is over. You are getting a vector only, but in scalar product, you will not get this I, j and k. Why we are getting I, j and k? Because cross product is already a vector. If cross product, a three-dimensional vector will be a three-dimensional vector only. So here you are getting this as equal to, this when you multiply, you will get this is equal to 7i. 7i. This one multiply when you get, you will get is equal to minus j. Minus j. And last one when you multiply, you will get minus 5k, you will get. So this is what is called A cross B. How to do A cross B? That's also done. See very carefully the method I have explained. Then you will get the idea about this, right? So this is another question. Next question I am going to give you is, and it is again a homework question I am giving you, right? This is a homework question, because if all the questions are done by the teacher only, then you will not get any practice at all. So this is a question 6, what I am going to explain, I'm going to give you as a homework. All the students will practice that question also. Also, you will pick up so many questions from your textbook. There must be, everybody must purchase a reference textbook. Many companies are publishing, right? I'm not telling you that you must purchase a book of a particular company only, any book, because all books have lot of questions and other things are described in that you can use, right? This question is this one, like this. If a vector A is equal to vector I plus 2j minus 3k, and vector B is equal to, and vector B is equal to minus 2i plus 3j minus 5k, minus 5k. Find the value of vector A cross vector B. First question, right? This is first question. Again, second question. Second question is what? Modulus vector A cross vector B. Again, three unit vector in the direction of vector A cross vector B. First of all, you will find vector A cross vector B. Then that vector A cross vector B divided by the product of the magnitude AB. A cross B divided by AB is equal to unit vector in the direction of, right, A cross B. So this question you have to do at home, right? After knowing the idea about, I think if you go through these lectures very sincerely, with a full concentration, then you will be able to do questions like this. Once or twice, if you are able to do questions, then your interest will increase. So purchase a lot of paper, bundle of paper, and keep with you, keep in front of you, and you must have a separate place, a table and other thing. Table will be there with the full facilities, and go on doing. Yes, not only one subject, all subjects you have to study. So this is the topic today's about. Tomorrow, I think I shall be able to start with a new lesson. Most probably that will be linear motion. That means motion of the body in a straight line. Right? So till then, bye-bye. Thank you very much.